What's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode. And real quick before we get into today's video, just making this intro real quick. Didn't really film anything yesterday when we went fishing. Didn't really expect to go fishing. It was like a last minute type of thing where we wanted to go fishing. And yeah, so pretty much what's going on is we've been fishing lakes, river, or lakes and ponds lately. And it's just been tough, and it's working its way into the fall. It's last week August, first week of September-ish, just around there when this video is coming out. And pretty much right now, the best thing that's fishing is rivers and creeks for smallmouth and largemouth or whatever's in creeks. So yeah, pretty much we are going to be trying to find some good smallmouth creeks and rivers around my area, doing a little bit of creek adventures and just going from there. So hopefully in a few of these river and creek missions this fall, we'll get on some nice smallmouth. I've been told that there's some really nice smallmouth in some of these areas, and as you guys see, we find a smallmouth or two in this video. So stay tuned and let's hop into today's video.
Hey, it doesn't matter to me. I'm fine with anything. Well, you think the jig or that rooster tail is probably a better bet?
Well, I got a jig on right at the moment.
I'll throw a rooster tail then if you're throwing that. Works for me. This is what my buddy, well, my girlfriend's cousin uses. He uses these little rooster tails and. Yep, I think it just broke. Well, I guess that's an easy choice of what I'm throwing. Oh, there was a bite. Because it was fighting back. Usually on something like that, I would just say it's probably just a log or something, but that, like, I felt like two, three poles back. All right, so we are gonna go back to the rooster tail, whatever it's called. Got hung up in the first cast with the other one, so tying on another one. Yeah, I have the one on the jig, but did you have one or something? This is my last rooster tail though, so this seems like it would be a really good area since it kind of bends and filters some new stuff through. And when we were looking for the sunglasses, I found a fly rod, it was a newer fly rod, really nice one. I ended up selling it to get my money back for my sunglasses. And then other than that, we end up going a little bit farther down. My buddy went to look for my girlfriend's kayak and found it, and then he ended up calling me. He's like, I found another kayak too. So we found another kayak that was washed up against the against trees, and then a little farther down we found a life jacket and then like hats and stuff. We're like, that's a little scary and that's not good. So yeah, that was closer to where like Eagle City goes over top, where we found that. But we're like, that's not good. That's a scary thing to see. Ooh, there's a fish. It's a little guy. I don't know. It feels like a little guy, but. Is it? Sweet, look at that. Oh, he's got the awesome colors too.
Yeah, that's about average.
I'm fine with that.
That's about average. Nice. You'll tangle with a few bigger than that, but that's about average. I got fire.
I am fine with that. That's, I love how they have the red eyes too. Looky there, guys. Those colors are awesome. That's like the typical like river smallmouth you think about right there. There we go. That's awesome. I didn't even like, even when he was like real close, I couldn't even see him. I was casted right up there and right down there where it gets like really dark brush areas where he hit it. I thought I was just stuck at first. I'm happy now. I got a smallmouth. I told my buddy it was the first time I've ever been disappointed with catching a smallmouth when we were up on Erie and we were catching 10-inch smallmouth.
Yeah.
I'm like, I think now that just made me want to invest in a little bit more underspins or inline spinners. I've never really, like in lakes and stuff, I never really throw them. And I've never fished rivers really. Yeah, you got one? Is that a sucker? That's a catfish or a sucker or a shad, something like that. Shad. why did that thing hit that?
That's a carp.
That is a carp.
Must have hit it right on the bottom.
I bet that was a fun little fight.
It actually did.
Keep on bumping on these rocks on the way back up and it makes it feel like there's a fish.
Yeah.
Big fish. All right, well, looks like people are here fairly often because all the trash and stuff. Yeah. Oh yeah, this looks like a nice little area. Oh. Do what? Do you? On what? Hey, still got a fish though. Which twister tail? This thing?
Yep.
Hey, I'll toss that around. Yeah, something did. That's crazy. I would guess so. What was that? If only I brought a topwater box. Smallmouth? Wow. That's what was going after my little paddle tail. Well, got another one now. Yeah. At least you're getting some fish here or there.
Well, everyone, that's going to do for today's video. Like I said, I didn't plan on filming too much, so it's kind of just me having my GoPro on and fishing and a little bit of small talk here or there with Jerry, who I went out there with. Thank you, Jerry, for taking me out there and showing me a few spots. But like I said, our goal this fall is to figure out some rivers around my house that hold smallmouth in it. There's two rivers near my house that do hold smallmouth in them. It's just figuring out where to fish for them, like what spots to fish and what baits to fish, because I'm newer to river fishing. Mainly I've always fished lakes and ponds. So that's our goal for this fall. But anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed the little river or creek fishing video today. Plan on doing more of them. Got a lot more content coming out here soon between smallmouth fishing this fall, largemouth fishing once the fall bite turns back on, hunting. I mean, we're going to do a little bit of everything. So, thank you guys for watching, and we will see you guys in the next video.